Hey guys, welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved. Take a look, I've upgraded the beach house. What do you think? So, the last time that we were together, I'd come back, we had looted a green supply crate, and I didn't really get a chance to look at the loot too much, but I started to upgrade the beach house here, mainly in preparation for leaving it, because I just wanted to leave it in good shape. Put up some walls and give us a place to hang our hat when we're in the area. And then when we're done here fixing it up, we're going to move down south there where I found the green supply crate and probably create a more permanent base down there. So now, mainly what I'm going to be doing in this episode at first is I'm going to be showing you all the upgrades I've made to the base and then some of the things I've collected. We've also gone up a couple of levels. I want to show you what engrams that I had picked out and used. Obviously, some of the wood structures, doors, walls, doorways, things like that, and the ramp, and a couple other things. So I'm just going to get started. I've got all the torches lit. We should be able to see what we're doing. And as always, there's always a green supply crate tempting me in the background every time I'm trying to talk to you folks. But we're not going to bite today. That's already getting old. You can tell because when it has the circle on top, it's still in the air. Once the crate reaches the ground, that little circle on the top of the beacon goes away. And then the durability on the crate starts reducing. It starts at 100 and will count down to 0 until it finally disappears. You don't have a terribly long time. I'm guessing it's somewhere between 5 and 10 minutes to get to it. So we have no idea how long that's been there. So chances are the best thing to do is to find a fresh one that still has the circle on top. And that'll give you the maximum amount of time to get to it. So as you see right here, we put a ramp right in front. Climb right up. I used to have sort of a two-tier floor. I took that out and put this ceiling piece right here to extend the porch. Inside, I had to redo this a little bit. I had to move the bed and the floor because the crates that were next to the house got stuck on the floor the first time. The mortar and pestle and the supply crate over here pretty much stayed the same. I didn't have to move them. Over here, you can see I moved the supply crates down a little bit and added this ladder. So we'll climb up the ladder. And you see we got ourselves a nice little perch. Switch to a different view. So that'll give us a place to kind of scout things out. Maybe if we see something that we want to tame, we can shoot with arrows from up here, some narcotic arrows. Or we can just hang out here to relax without having to worry about things coming up on us. So over here, I got a couple of things. So actually, in the inventory first, we've got a blueprint for a large storage box. Now, we had picked up the blueprint and a large storage box in the supply crate, as well as a paintbrush and a new cooking pot. So this blueprint will actually allow us to build storage boxes without having the engram. We just click on the blueprint, craft the item. Now, from what I understand, if you have a blueprint to an item and it's a high enough level, it'll actually make a better item than the engram, the standard engram will do. So you could actually craft master level items by having the right blueprint to them. Now in here, besides the food and everything that we have, you'll notice we have a dodo egg. Now Dee had laid an egg. I don't think I showed it on camera, but right now in the game, eggs do not spawn baby dinosaurs or dodos or Fiomias. None of that. Actually, I don't even know if Felix and a mate could have an egg. They're mammals after all. But dinosaur eggs do not hatch, but you can use them as food, and supposedly they satisfy a lot of hunger and help you heal. You can also use them to create kibble. And the kibble can be used to tame dinosaurs by creating their favorite type of kibble with their favorite type of egg. Will help speed up the process from what I understand. Or as favorite food for maybe one of your pet dinosaurs. Let's see, in here we've got the cooking pot that we picked up. And the large storage bin. Now, I think I'm actually going to place the storage bin. And I'm going to make a couple of changes here. But first, let's take a look in this one. We've got some chitin, some keratin. And then in this one. But I'm going to place the large storage box over here. Get it as close to the fence as we can. Right there. Yeah, could have been a little straighter. So in here, I'm going to put the cooking pot. I'm going to put the blueprint in here, but I'm going to hold on to that for now because I think we're going to make another one. Actually, you know what? Let's do that now. So that takes 50 wood, 35 thatch, and 25 fiber. So we're going to craft that item now. Do I have enough to make a second one? No, we need more wood. That's okay. Two will be fine for now. We'll make another one later. I'm going to keep the slingshot handy in case we come across something that we want to tame. Put it in place of the torch for now. And what else? I think that is it for now. It's a brand new day. The sun's about to rise. Let's put the storage kit as close as we can to the fence. There we go. That's about the best we can do. What do I have on? Let's see. Thatch. Lots of thatch. Tons of thatch. More thatch. Fiber. You know, fiber's very good for your diet. It'll keep you regular. But I think in this case, too much is too much. Okay, we'll take all this dino feces out of here. And destroy this case. Not gonna need it anymore. And this one is empty as well. See ya! What's in this one? This one is empty as well. Okay. Bye-bye, case. And then last but not least is this one here. Now, do I have anything to add to this? I'm not going to put the feces in there. It doesn't make a difference because it's a game, but just something about putting feces with your food. Yeah. I'm not going to do it. Alright, let's put the... We'll put the feces with the fiber and the thatch. I don't think they're... That sounds like a gross combination, necessarily. Alright, and... There was something I wanted to make. Trying my hardest to remember what it was. Just want to make sure the recording doesn't stop. I actually started doing this earlier in my recording, just quit on... I wanted to make some more narcotic, that was it. So I need narco berries and rotten meat. Now, I think at some point I had narco berries here. And I don't. And I don't seem to have any on me. I must have stored them all last time after I made the narcotic. I really don't remember, but I must have. It's the only thing that makes sense, right? So So we'll go here and find the engram for the narcotic. We'll add spoiled meat and narco berry. And we can make 8. So I'm going to make all 8. Alright. Let's move Felix out here. We're going to take him to collect some resources. But I'm going to take one of these guys with me. And I think I'm going to take Milo. Okay, so now, main things today. I'm bringing Milo just for protection when I'm off of Felix. But so the main things today are collecting wood, specifically, among other things, and capturing either a trike or a parasaur or anything that's on the list. So it's a trike, a parasaur, a raptor, and one of those new little dinosaurs are the main things on the list right now that we're kind of shopping for, looking for opportunities, if you want to call it that. Now, I'm wondering if this trike over here isn't stuck on this tree. It's a male trike, level 2. He's definitely stuck. Level 2. That's not very high. You know what? He's stuck there now. Let's take a look around. I see trikes stuck on trees pretty much every time I go out. It's almost rare that they're not. There we go. There's another one right here. Okay, a level 5 female trike. I think it's about time we added a female to the pack. What do you think? Felix, how rude. She's gonna be one of the new pack members. Don't be so rude. Alright, so I am gonna put him to passive. And temporarily, I'm gonna put neutral, passive. There we go. So now they shouldn't attack unless I specifically tell them to. Now I only have 2 stones on me. Is there anything I can... Yeah. Oh! Wrong instrument. I was collecting flint. Okay, that's more than enough stone. Guys, come over here. You guys hang right here. And we'll give you the stay command. Alright, Miss Trike. I do this in your best interest. I know it doesn't seem like it at the moment. Ugh. Why me? There we go. It's a good thing she can't move. I'd be dead meat. Come on, clown. Seriously? Okay, finally. There we go. She's completely unconscious. About 75% health. Put some narcotic in there. And I have no berries on me. No. Inventory. Let's grab the male berries. Felix doesn't really seem to be bothering with them very much. Okay. Now we can set their aggression up because they won't attack her anymore. Right. We'll put them on neutral. Felix will have it just on our target. Let's see. Stay there, Felix. You, come with me. There we go. So what I need to do is I need to collect berries. Oh. Yeah, no, I can do without that right now. Let's go this way. Now, one thing I was actually unaware of before. I don't know if I mentioned it in the last video. I know I was doing it off camera, but I'm not sure if I actually brought it up. But Felix can collect thatch from trees. Maybe a little wood here and there, but mainly thatch. It's like using a pick on a tree, for instance. But when it comes to the berries and things like that, he can't collect them on his own. I have to collect them for him. Now, it's kind of come to my attention that trikes can. So if you're driving a trike around, or riding a trike around, and you attack a bush, the trike will collect all the berries on the bush. And that's great, because the more animals we add to the pack here, the more we're going to need food. And it really was getting a little hard to keep Felix fed as it was with all the running around that we do. He constantly needs food. And I don't want to get too bogged down with that. So that's one of the reasons I put trikes on the list of things we were looking for. That and the fact that they're pretty strong, and I think they'll really help us in a fight, especially if we have to face carnos and things like that. I think they'll make all the difference. I mean, on their own, they tend to lose, but they're not aggressive. But just like with Felix on his own, he's not much, but I mean, look at how well he's done with the pack. He can take some hits. And by the time we get into the fight, he starts taking all the hits and tanks the creatures. The Dilos do all the damage. Now just think if we had a raptor or two. Oh. I don't want to get cocky and think we can take on a T-Rex, but it'd be pretty nice. And there's always safety in numbers. Oh, there we are. I went a lot further than I thought. With me, Milo. Doing good enough. Taming effectiveness is 98%. So now I am gonna give Felix any berries other than the male berries to hold on to. And narco berries I'll hold on to. I don't think you'll eat them, but not gonna take the chance. Keep all the berries, the male berries on the trike here. We still have a ways to go. Alright. So, I think we're going to be here when it gets dark. So I'm going to make a little preparation for this. First, we're going to knock down these trees. First, I'm going to fix my hatchet. And got to do this one carefully so we don't hurt her. Okay. It's a little better. About a third the way there. Then, I'm going to craft up some torches, and we're going to light up the area. About four of them should do. Don't need the slingshot anymore. It's really only good for knocking them out, really, I mean, with the bow and arrow now. So we're going to put one close to her. And then we'll put one over here near these trees. Put another one over here near these trees. Another one over here. The reason I'm doing this is I'm actually preparing. Oh. Did we run out? I thought I had four. But I'm actually preparing to give me time to chop some wood, and that's why I'm kind of putting it in strategic areas. So I thought. Okay. How you doing for weight, Felix? Pretty good. Alright, let's collect some wood. Wood's the main thing we need to finish the beach house. Oh, I can't move. Ooh, something's going on here. Something bad's happening. I forgot the... Is he gonna come close enough? Nope. I can't move. Let's see, what can I put down? I'll put this wood down. Is that enough? Yeah, just enough. Alright, let's see, we'll give you the most weight. Let's give you all the fiber. How'd that do? Yeah, a lot better. I guess that's where most of the weight was, and all this wood. This up. And we're gonna put that wood on there. No wait, no, he's up, he leveled, right? So Felix is basically going to become more of a pack animal than our main source of transportation. I'm definitely going to take him out to stretch his legs here and there, but I need him to be able to carry a lot of weight, so I'm going to add to that. Okay. And it looks like Milo leveled. It could have been a while ago. So now Milo is our damage dealer. And so I'm going to upgrade him there. Two... Three levels. Wow, it's been a while since I've checked them. I don't really care about weight, but let's add a little bit. Because they do loot the corpses of the creatures we kill sometimes. Okay, our unconsciousness with the tricare is getting a little bit low for my taste. And we're definitely going to have to use some narcoberries. So well, the narcotic, so I'm going to remote use it. And I'll probably have to do it at least one more time, based on the looks of it. Plenty of berries in there, so she should be okay. So you're all upgraded, Felix? Alright, how about myself? We're gonna level soon. Got 50 engram points. Alright. I'm gonna, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to cycle the recording and exit and backup save just in case anything goes wrong. And I'll be back.